Game Catcher. There we go. Yeah, window capture didn't do it. So this is Space Agent. I am currently parked in the Pluto Charon system, and this is Styx here, the dwarf moon, one of the dwarf moons of Pluto. Pluto is here, so we can actually go to Charon. Slowly. And it's quite nice because they actually have the textures of, you know, from the New Horizons mission. I mean, there's a big chunk here obviously that hasn't been seen, so it's all blurry, but you can see at least the parts that were imaged. And the interesting thing is there's a distant sun. I don't know what that is. Is that as a nebula, apparently. But we go to Pluto. I can just see where that is. You can actually see it's got a faint atmosphere as well there. Now, if we center object, now one of these might do it. Rotate with object. Speed up time. There we go. You can actually see that they are both locked to each other, Pluto and Charon. So here's Charon in the foreground. Obviously got most of the imaged hemisphere here. Pluto in the background. The rotation periods of both of these are exactly the same. The orbital periods are the same. It's fully tidally locked, so this surface isn't rotating relative to this, and this one isn't rotating relative to that. They're just hanging over the same spot, basically. And I should probably stick my camera up there. There we go. I can see me gesticulating. Yeah, so that's pretty awesome. Also, and I've sort of sped up time here, so if I slow time down and go to let's go to Nix, which is another tiny little asteroidal moon that orbits the pair. Around and see the pair in the background over there, and let's see what happens. If we speed up time, so if I think do that. So I don't want to do that. I want to follow object, maybe. I'll try and figure out if I can keep this here, and then track that one. Can I do that? Be losing sticks, but from Styx's sorry, Nix's perspective, we can actually watch Charon orbiting Pluto here, which is quite nice. Imagine some music happening or something. I thought this game actually had music. But I have to see. So there we go. So you got the Magellanic Clouds in the background. It's coming into view. And then there's the Milky Way, which we are in, of course. So, do sound, yeah, wasn't there? There we go. There we go. Got a bit of background noise. So yeah, now the fun thing about this thing is that we can go absolutely anywhere. Oh, here we are. So, for example, I believe there's a way to enter a thing to go to somewhere. Not that one. Find object. So, if we want to go to Earth, for example, we can just zip over and see the Earth and get the right way up. There we are. And there's the sun, and we got the night lights as well. That's pretty sweet. Aurora as well up here. We can also I don't know what this is actually going to be like here, but oh wow, look, you can actually see the aurora actually have height. That's pretty spiffy. Look at that. Hey, look at this. That's pretty cool. So we are now actually over the aurora, and they move. Oh, this is brilliant. Look at that. That's pretty sweet. So we can actually see the aurorae over the Earth's atmosphere. Slow down a bit. Now, I don't know if there's actually a topography thing going on here, but we can head in. Atmosphere under the sea. That's what this is. It goes a little bit crazy. Evidently, I'm coming over the Pacific or something. See if I can get some land. Some land. Yeah, so there's not much in the way of topography here, but you can actually settle yourself down and just watch the sun go around the sky. Speed up time. Sunset comes. Bit of atmospheric diffraction, and the stars come out. Very nice. And then we're up again. So we got a nice bit of time lapsing going on, and then we can just accelerate away. back. Past the Aurora again. Very nice. So, we're not just limited to the solar system here. North America. Well, nice. We can go elsewhere. So let's pick Procyon, a nearby star. It's got no planets, but it does have a white dwarf companion. We can head over to that and check it out. You basically adjust your speed with a mouse wheel. Oh. And there's our white dwarf. Now, this is a system without planets. So let's head for one that has planets. Okay, let's find a system. So, I think nearby it's got the real planets like that we know that are there. As you go further away, it has planets that are just fictional, basically. So, we can pick HIP 31121. That is 800 or so light years away. But it has planets. Fictional ones, of course, but let's get this. Let's see where I can put this webcam. Let's put me down here, and then you can see everything going on. So, here we are at an orange giant. We can also, if you want the full elite effect, you can muffle the exposure and see the all the what do they call them, spicules or something, all convection cells basically on the giant, or we can just revert it back to normal. So we have to undo that. Let's see what we've got here. We have a scorched desert planet orbiting rather close. That's this guy. You may have noticed they have little comet tails. They're being evaporated away. So this is another thing. This guy is pretty hot. 977C, barely holding on to an atmosphere apparently. Very close to the star. I mean, look at this. This is just nuts. Whoa. not having a good time of it. It also has some moons, which we can head over to. That's a very stretched out asteroid by the looks of it. But yeah, I do kind of like the overexposed look here, because like you're right up close to the star. You're not going to be gently lit. I mean, if we wanted to, let's have a look here. If we wanted to get the exposure looking a bit more like Elite or something, this is what we'd see, which, you know, is not as exciting. So let's have a look. We can land here as well. And the star dominating the view here. Somewhere there was a planet. There we go. Coming into view. Pretty sweet. I mean, how realistic this all is, I don't know, but I mean, these are tiny little asteroid moons, so I suppose it's not unlikely that they could be together like this, close to the planet. Let's up the exposure to proper levels. Let's get down here and see what we can see. Red hot planet. Oh no, this is pretty cool. So here's your star. I believe some of these mountain sides may still be illuminated. Yeah, look over there. Got the big volcano. That's pretty cool. Catching the sun's rays. Now, I mean, really, the whole thing should be illuminated here. I mean, again, we might have a bit of a problem with the light coming from the center of the star or some such. But yeah, I mean, technically the whole thing here should be illuminated because we've got half the star above the horizon. So not even the space engine is beyond having lighting issues. But that's pretty sweet. And obviously you can see as well, there is topography. So let's go somewhere else here. It's another desert. Where's the little cooler? See, it's interesting, the temperatures are all wacky here. This one's at 12 AU, that's at 23, but it's hot. Got some greenhouse effects going on. There's an ice world out there. That should be alright. Let's head out to that gas giant. Wondering, yeah, like these planets or the moons around it should be reasonably habitable, but they're all a bit too small. The temperate desert world, asteroids. Oof. Yeah, it's got a whole bunch of asteroids and things. Many, 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 many asteroids. These are quite far off as well. Yeah, let's get rid of those. So let's just head for the temperate desert moon that is kind of Mars size. It's a bit on the cold side, minus 21 degrees. But here we are. Again with some aurora. Let's watch them flicker. That's the nice thing here, is that, you know, some of the planets do have topography. So you can swoop among the mountain ranges. And down into the valleys and the lowlands. They've even got some bedding, which is interesting. Textures, very nice. So before we head out from here, let's head off to this ice planet because there's some interesting things on there. Speed up a bit. Zip zip. Because some of these have got some, whoops, interesting features on them. I don't just crash into it. You've got to kind of learn to control your speed in this game. Well, I hesitate to call it a game, it's a thing. Screenshot generator or something, I suppose, but. So yeah, there are some, you get these little crack-like features here that can show up. This one's, oops, not a very good one. There's a much better one that I saw on another planet, but it's clearly supposed to be like the cracks on Europa and Enceladus, which I thought was quite cute. Got these ridges and things. Here we go, this is more like it. So now we're like flying along like a ridge on Europa, that kind of thing, which is really quite cute. I've got to wait for the textures to load in, but there we go. So, further afield I feel we should go. And if anyone is watching and wants me to go anywhere in particular, then let me know in the chat. But we can literally go anywhere. Like, over there is a small Magellanic cloud. So let's go there, shall we? Now, that was a bit naff from here, but let's get further in. And suddenly, here we are, inside the small Magellanic Cloud. It's not a place you can go to in Elite Dangerous at the moment. There's also globular clusters up here. The large Magellanic Cloud over there, and over here we got this rather spiffy view of the Milky Way, which is rather nice. And that, of course, is 100 billion stars or so. But we've got stars here too. Let's head over in this direction. Whoops. There's a nice little nebula over here. Maybe there's a star near it. Where do we want to Well, hang on, let's have a look. We can actually search for stars within a 10 light year radius. See, we've got a red dwarf very nearby. A brown dwarf nearby. I don't know if I've seen a brown dwarf in this game. Let's go to you, shall we? Oops. There we go. Gotta slow down a bit. So what's that? That's an L dwarf. That's a T dwarf. What's the? I haven't quite figured out how to use this map yet, but this is the one I use as a reference usually. So let's have a look at the L dwarf. It's kind of gonna look more like a star, since they kind of are stars. I mean, they're burning. They're not burning fusion. They just finished. Burning hydrogen, they just finish burning it, or deuterium anyway. Now he has planets. A cold Selina, that's like a moon-like body. Desert, ice world, frozen ice world, frozen ice world. Yeah, because obviously these are pretty far away. Well, they're close to the dwarf, but the dwarf's not emitting much light. So, where is the thing? Here we are. 8 million kilometers away. So not very far. This one, for example. But it's just not enough heat, basically. To keep it warm. A couple of moons. It's very orange due to the dwarf and its own moons. Ooh, as well. This big one could be more interesting. Just a big, heavily cratered. Does actually, oh, that's interesting. It does kind of scale with the size of the body, the surface features. Because if we have a look, oops. into the day side here. So the sun just happens to be lying right in the plane of the Magellanic Cloud. Yeah, like there's the sun. And we're just flying above the surface here. Pretty sweet. We got the nebula in the background there, which is looking rather fantastic. Music's rather good as well, quite impressed with that. Very epic feeling. And here we are walking along the ground basically. You can just spend forever just swooping around in this game. It's really quite cool. Oh, big crater. And then... oh wow, there you go. Milky Way behind the nebula. Very nice. Whoop. And there we go. I think my I think this may be about to crash here. Whoop, let's have a look. Yep, there we go. It actually died. So let's get back in. There's got a big error there. Should hopefully remember where we were. There we go. That was being a bit too ambitious, I feel. Context plane, let's try that. So here we go. Leaving whatever this planet's called. Right, so having visited the small Magellanic Cloud, why don't we pop into the large Magellanic Cloud. In fact, hang on, do we have the Terrestrial Nebula? No, we don't. Is that in here though? What would that be? Doridus? No? Not in there. Never mind. Tarantula Nebula is in the large Magellanic Cloud. But we can do that. Oops. There we go. It's head over there. So again, a misty little region here. Let's see what that nebula is. Whoops. Not go quite so fast. It's a diffuse nebula, but there is a globular cluster nearby, which could be quite fun. Now these are fun. They are very dense packets of stars. They're only about, well, let's have a look. That's 34 light years away. That's 28 light years away, so they're about the same distance. So I guess what, that's 30 light years, 30, 40 light years, and they're all packed in tight there. And some of these stars are going to have their own planets, which will have interesting views. So let's go and see one of these. Orange dwarf. What we got here? A hot desert, hot gas giant, warm Selina, temperate desert. Let's go over to the temperate desert world. You can already see how the night sky is going to look over here. So, another thing this has over Elite, it has shadows. It's rather awesome. Not only does it have shadows, though, but if we speed up time here, see the moons coming around. So, note that we can see the dark side here. Let's see if we can do this without the sun in the way. See, you can actually see the light reflecting from the sun off the asteroid's moon's surface. Except it just sun rose at an inopportune moment there. But if we hop over here, let's keep an eye out here. See, it's a little brighter. Now, the only snag with this is that the sun is not actually illuminating the asteroid while it's behind the planet, but it's still pretty cool. And you also do have here you can see you've got planet shine on the asteroid surface. Like, you don't see it here because planet's on this side, but if you follow it around, you might see a little more brightness there. As it's getting the light reflected off the day side of the planet, which is pretty nice. Meanwhile, over here, the sky is full of stars. Let's head over, actually. Very Charon-like. But yeah, have a look. Slow time down a bit here. And have a look at the night sky. Very normal in this direction. I mean, it's a big mess of the Magellanic Cloud. But over here, just full of stars, all packed in this like 30 light year radius, and then right above it all is the Milky Way. Pretty sweet. I do like that. There's a small Magellanic Cloud. Now we could go even further afield. The asteroid moons, very nearby. that actually, I don't know if they would be torn apart. Depends how big they are. 40 kilometers, 99 kilometers. Yeah, they might be actually a bit too close. Might have got torn apart by tidal forces, really. But let us go even further afield. Oops. No, I didn't want to do that. And now, of course, all these things are fictional here. Like, we don't have no idea what planets would be in the Large Magellanic Cloud. But let's go. Well, have a look. M31, would it be in there? Must be in here. Yeah, Andromeda. Andromeda Galaxy. 2 million light years away. I guess all these other things are other galaxies. There we are. And what's this guy? M110, it's an elliptical. We have the Andromeda Galaxy. So let's pop over here. This is a satellite galaxy. So, from out here, like, they're just plates basically, right? But as you get nearer, see, they actually turn into disks. So what's up here? So this up here is a core, isn't it? Oops. That's the core of the galaxy, pretty much. What we got here? Why can't we click on anything? Hello. There we go. The blue supergiant. A red supergiant. See, this would be quite interesting. Let's have a look around here. Very densely packed stars here. So obviously these are very bright. Let's see what the system says. We got a O4 supergiant and a B subgiant. Didn't it say there were planets here? No, I don't think it did. Oh well. So here's that's what that looks like anyway. What's nearby? Of course, we have bazillion things here. 3,000. All right, we've got like 3,000 systems within 10 light years. I mean, within 1 light year. We've actually got a system within a light year, which is pretty impressive. That's a very close thing. Let's go visit the M star nearby. So this is a M dwarf star. Cool, Selina. So it's a double planet, that one. Two small moons there. Lots of tiny moons. Ooh. Yeah, small moons. Small moons. Didn't want the dwarf moons. So not a particularly exciting system. This one might be interesting. Head for this little ice giant. Also a bit non-circular by the looks of it, or non-spherical, it's a bit elliptical. But I mean, there's so many stars here that, you know, there's not really much in the way of black space. And we can go over to this moon. Nice. It too has a Rory. Land. Come in at least. So this is also a really good thing about this game. That, you know, you can land on atmospheric planets for one thing. But you look at the planet up there, you're just seeing what's illuminated, which is exactly what you should be seeing. And as you watch time go by, it should get more and more illuminated. There's your, well, wacky things happening. You can say there's your shadow, but not entirely sure what happened there. Let's go find the planet again. Maybe it doesn't like time lapsing. Here we go. Let's try that. Might have been giving it a bit too much food for thought there. So yeah, there's a moon shadow going by. And that's just awesome, especially with the clouds going by. We just went into eclipse there or something. Oh wow, look at that. That's pretty sweet. Big nearby in the moon. Well, that is cool. Of course, can't see the moon anymore because it's hidden by the atmosphere. But now we're in the shadow. Oh, that was pretty cool. How about that? Out again. Some weird dynamics going on here. I guess we sort of caught up with it there. There it is. That's pretty awesome, eh? Just grabbed a screenshot of it there. I'm not entirely sure how you turn off the UI, but you can take screenshots without it there. Here we go, that'll seem better. I mean, that is a pretty cool sight, really. I am speeding time up here as well. Yeah, I think this is all randomly generated. Like, I don't know if it's, I don't think it's different each time or something, but you know, I don't know if you would be able to come back to this specific spot. Maybe you can, but you know, everywhere in the universe is, you can go anywhere, like basically. You could go to a galaxy 20 billion light years away, and it would make a whole bunch of random things. It's pretty sweet, really. But yeah, you can just kind of sit here and watch the planets and the moons move. And there's the Andromeda Nebula, the Andromeda Galaxy in the background there. Let's head out. That was a nice spot. Let us actually head out. Of this little satellite galaxy into the Andromeda Galaxy. That is pretty cool. Down into the disk. So yeah, where to? To the bulge? To the core? We already went somewhere dense and crowded. Let's go somewhere that isn't. Let's go out into the edge. The halo stars. And that one. Orange luminous supergiant. It's an orange supergiant. See what that looks like. Patchy, apparently. Oh, look at that, you can see even like swirls around it. Like gas being thrown off. We like lower the exposure, you can see it's a big ugly gas giant or big sort of puffy ball of gas. Apparently, some poor schmuck is orbiting really close to you. Let's have a look at this. Ridiculously close thing. full exposure. Brain is seared away. I mean, that is a bonkers system. You wouldn't want to be that close. That's probably getting shorn away. Let's back out a little. Let's have a look at what we got here. Ooh, there's a black hole. Let's go have a look at the black hole, shall we? Apparently the black hole has planets. There we go. Of course, not actually seeing it. There we go. Now, this does have your warping effects, as we shall see. Like that. Which is pretty spiffy. Unlike the ones in Elite, the black hole is actually black, which is nice. I don't know what happens if we get too close. Kilometers. There. Well, that's what the inside of a black hole looks like. Not entirely sure I want to get that much closer. Oh, look at that! It's all blue shifted. That is sweet! Because this wasn't blue before, was it? Let's see if we can get further out and see? Now it's all like normal colours. Oh, that is neat. I did not know they had that in here. So there is your black hole. Blue shifting away. What happens if we get too close? Get some nasty tides. We are now in the black hole, pretty much. 15 meters. I don't even know how to get out of here now. No? Did it go anywhere? Oh, here we go. That way was out. There we go. Tiny little speck of light! It's presumably the entire universe compressed into a... There we go. Apparently it just jumps. Oops. Trying to get out here. Come on. Ah! I was almost out. Speed up too much, I can't get out. it's out. Come on, where are you? Yep. That's everywhere. Okay. Let's see if we can get out. There we go. That was kind of scary. So this black hole apparently has some planets around it. Maybe we should go see what that looks like. Because they can't be fun places. Now that, of course, illuminated by the supergiant companion. She is over there. Now where is the black hole? There, apparently. Am I still, I'm still on fast time. Whoops, the galaxy is appearing. So, do we not have, we not see the distortion of the black hole there? I don't know. Oh, that's probably there. That's probably the issue there. Am I locked onto the black hole here? Sure, what's going on there? Yeah, I picked one that's probably hard to see, is why. Like, there's nothing in the background to show it off. And I'm zooming through time here, apparently. That's a warm asteroid. That's beyond the black hole, or it is not, though. So now we might be able to see it. No, it's over there. It's proving hard to see. So that said, we've got a pretty nice view of the Andromeda Galaxy here. What else? Where else could we go? There's like one more spot. How about the Triangulum Galaxy? Or I suppose you could pop over to the Trifid Nebula. Whee! See what that looks like. Looks like a couple of gas clouds. But I bet if there was anything in between here, that would look quite nice. How about you? 20 planets with a nice view. What have we got here? We got a planet orbiting the pair. Another one orbiting the pair. Seven moons around that one. Now, you see, you could get some interesting lighting effects here. The nebulae might even cast some light. Let's have a look. There we are. Boink, there we are. Let's have a looky. Anything? So, I don't know if there's a setting that I can. Do here. Yeah, I'm not sure. But what we could do is perhaps get down on the surface here and see what things are like. Wow, that's pretty awesome. Now this is something you can't easily do in Elite. And it's just park yourself down and see if we can. Follow that. I wanted to track object. So let's see if we can actually do this. Let's go back to you again. See what I'm going to do here. Apparently that got a lot made a lot of headway there. Right, so what I want to do is get down on here. So that I can see both these things and then track object and is that going to work? Or is the planet just going to move around me? Yeah, I'm not sure. Not sure I can do this. Because I wanted to see these moving, but I don't think it's going to work. There's a way to set this up, but let's go. Where we go here. Let's go to this gas giant. I'm still tracking this thing, aren't I? I have to untrack. There hello. Don't track. I want to go to you. There we go. There we are. So, what have we got here? Can I untrack you, please? Or do something? There we go. Here we are. Yeah, the whole tracking and following thing is a little bit confusing sometimes. So, what moons do you have? Do you indeed have moons? Got something around here. Oh, unless they're like just little asteroids. Yeah, they're just little asteroids. You got moons? You got moons. Let's go to you instead. Yeah, this is Space Engine. It is pretty much just a sort of flying around space simulator. That's all it is. But yeah, it is pretty relaxing. The music is pretty fitting. You just swoop around planets and find cool things and take pretty screenshots. And the awesome thing about it is that the lighting is really, really good. Like, you know, here, for example, we're at the dark side of the gas giant. But it's lit up by, I would imagine, this, because there's light reflecting off this moon's surface. I think it's this one. Is it? Maybe not. It was illuminated by something anyway. To go back. Oh, we're way over there. Oh, that was a bit far out. It's illuminated by some moon's surface anyway. You also have ring shadows. So let's try that again. Yeah, it's lit by something. I don't know what it is lit by, but whoops. But you do have the ring shadows here. Let's see if we can speed up time a bit. There we go. Oh, unless it's the other star. That might be what's illuminating it. That would make more sense. So yeah, look, yeah, it's the other star. Because there's one star up here. And probably before too long, the other star will arrive up here. Yeah, oh, that's pretty sweet. So yeah, that demonstrates something that Elite can't do. Sadly, they are not eliminated by the Nibbly, but that's pretty cool. A sort of Saturnian gas giant. Whizzing around. And all I'm doing here is speeding up time. As you can see, I think, going down in the bottom left corner of the thing. So that's pretty sweet. Then, well, where else to go really for now? Probably home. let's go. We're now in the Milky Way again. Let's go back home, shall we? A place close to my heart. Let's see what they got. Hey, home sweet home. Ganymede, biggest moon of Jupiter. And what I'm basically named after. And I presume Jupiter's back there, yep. Everything's the right way around because this is the hemisphere that should be pointing away from Jupiter. And over here, oh, this would be quite cool actually. This little area is somewhere I spent quite a lot of my PhD looking at. Byblos. I suppose it's not actually cratered. It's not got the topography. But you can see it's very low resolution, but you can see it's a crater in this band of terrain here, brighter terrain. It's a shame they haven't got the topography properly done there. That's pretty cool. Can go and visit Europa as well while we're at it. Yep, there's Galileo Regio. Big crater of Sirius. I think that's Tross. I think. It's been a while since I've looked at all the maps. So, according to the shine, I can vaguely see some rings. That's pretty cool. There's a shadow of something. Let's go have a look at Europa while we're here. Whew. Itself very well there. Bit too close. There we go. That's what I want to do. So, yeah, the speed thing takes a bit of getting used to here. So, what have we got here? Any recognizable landmarks? I don't know which way north is here, so I'm a bit lost. Oh, there's Thrace and Thera. Macaulay, another of my favourite spots. These are all jumbled up chaos terrains as we know now. But for a while we thought they were lava flows, like water lava. Galileo proved that wrong. Galileo mission, that is, not the person. Cool. Should have a look at Io while we're here. I wonder how they've handled the volcanoes. Pretty neat. Oh, there there's some interesting stuff going on here. Glowy red spots. It's pretty cool. Well, pretty hot actually, but that is pretty sweet. So what if we fly down to them? Let's go visit a volcano, because these are all active volcanoes. See what's if there's one kind of on the day side here. Oops, a bit too close. If we can find one that's actually trying to figure out what my controls are. If we can find one that's actually on the day side. See what it looks like. And maybe, oh, there we are. There we are. That's there, just little smudgy things here. That's a shame, but it's still pretty cool that they do that. Let's have a look at Amalthea. That's even closer to Jupiter. Oh, you've got the shape right, that's really cool. Long axis pointing towards Jupiter. Oh wow, look at that. Yep. Let's watch that swirl by. Into the shadow. Barnard loop back there. That's very cool. Long axis again, correctly pointing towards Jupiter. Very nice. Well, I suppose we shouldn't leave out poor old Callisto. Always gets neglected. And then I think we'll call that a day. There we are. Often underrated moon. Covered in craters. But it's got a few big ones. See if we can find the bee. Keep it in the background. Where is the one I'm looking for? Unilluminated, probably. Well, let's see. Put it down there. Ah, there we are. There we are. That is what I'm looking for. The mighty Valhalla Basin. very big impact basin. Sweep around there. Well, here we are on Callisto. Right, I at that point am going to go head back to Earth. Home sweet home. And there's a bang on view for the Aussies. Probably quicker to go this way around if I want to go where I am. Okay, it's over here. Here somewhere. So yeah, here we go. Leave it there. Thanks for joining me. Hope that was fun. It was quite relaxing and chill. And I hope you enjoyed the Lego things. Sorry for all the little technical issues we had at the beginning there. I guess I know better next than to connect two cameras to the computer next time. Shame, because that would have been rather nice to have had a table camera. But that's all for now. Next time, posted the schedule on the Twitch page and Twitters and so on. But next stream will not be on Saturday. I'm out on Saturday. So the next stream will be on Tuesday, a week time. And I will be playing Submerged, which I just discovered in my Steam library and I completely forgot what I bought. But it looks like a pretty neat little story game. I don't know if it's like 2 hours or 4 hours or something. So I might get through it in one session, I don't know. If not, we'll probably get through it in two. And I think next Tuesday is on, I think the Saturday after is on, if I have a look. I think the 19th and the 23rd are on. 26th is off, and then the 30th is on again. So coming up next will be Submerged for as long as that goes on for, and then after that I think I'll do Abzu, which is another short game. That should be one session, and then New Year, who knows. I think I've got a few little ideas of what I want to do, but we'll see. So I will leave it there. Thanks for joining me, and see you next week for Submerged. Okay, cheers then. Bye-bye.